So election day is now just 47 days out. And when it comes to the presidential election, we usually see an endorsement from the Teamsters Union. But this year, that won't be the case. As reporter Connor Hansen explains, it is the first time the union hasn't endorsed either candidate in several decades.
Former President Donald Trump held his first major rally since a foiled assassination attempt at his golf club over the weekend. He's celebrating the Teamsters Union's decision not to endorse either presidential nominee this year. The highly influential labor group has endorsed a Democrat in every election since 1996, which was the last time it decided not to pick.
We interviewed both candidates, and we were seeking commitments from both candidates, and we couldn't get solid commitments on our core issues.
They endorse the Democrats automatic for many, many decades. But you know what? They said, they looked at her, they said, we're not going there.
Vice President Harris and President Biden have long touted being a strong pro-union administration.
This is a president and a vice president that has fought hard for unions throughout their administration.
The Harris-Walz campaign sent out an email highlighting endorsements from individual Teamsters chapters in the key states of Michigan, Wisconsin, and Nevada. And new Fox polling shows Harris gained ground against Trump, now leading nationally by 2 percentage points. Other Democrats are coming to the vice president's defense and pushing back on the Teamsters' decision.
I think that this is really about Sean O'Brien's leadership more than it is about Kamala Harris, who cast the tie-breaking vote to bail out Teamster pensions.
The last Republican the Teamsters endorsed was George H.W. Bush in 1988. In New York, Connor Hansen, Fox News.